Hello guys and welcome back to the channel. Now guys, the Ambode Tinubu beef continues to evolve. Of course, we're in the EFCC stage at the moment. Of course, you guys would have seen videos on my channel, and if you have not seen them, then please go have a look. They are the latest video that I posted. So you should have seen videos on my channel of the EFCC going to raid Ambode's homes. I say homes because they went to raid him in Epe and they also went to raid him in Ikoyi. So they went to raid his homes effectively. So now Ambode has now come out to now clap back at this going son, to now state his side of the story, to just bring Nigerians up to speed with what his position is with regards to the going on that we're seeing at the moment. So with that, I bring you this. Ambode reacts to EFCC raid, reveals next line of action. So that's the headline. Ambode reacts to EFCC raid, reveals next line of action. So now let's get into it. Former governor of Lagos State, Akinwumi Ambode, has reacted to the EFCC raid on his home earlier today. Ambode on Tuesday urged his supporters and the general public to remain calm and law-abiding, as there was no cause for alarm. Ambode, in a statement by his media aide, Mr. Habib Aruna, spoke on the background of a search by the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, EFCC, on his Epe country home and Parkview Ikoyi residence, where the anti-graft agencies conducted the exercise without incident. He said the commission till date has not opened any direct communication with him on any issue, adding that he was ready and willing to respond if and when they do so. So now let's just pause there for a moment, because that is quite pertinent. So now the EFCC, in the previous video that I did, were saying that they are abiding by the law and they are following due process. So now if you are following due process and you are abiding by the law, then surely you must indicate to the person that you are investigating that we're investigating you for this. You know, you can't just go and randomly raid somebody. You are not the FBI, you are an Economic and a Financial Crimes Commission person. So this is not a national security issue. This is not some military positioning. This is an economic and a financial situation. So with an economic and financial situation, is only money. So you cannot override human rights and the right to be informed and the right to know where you stand in life, to go behind their back and yet just suddenly appear in their home and start to raid them. Prominent person like Ambode as well. So you cannot do that. So if you are saying you are following the rule of law, then the rule of law surely does not allow for this. And this guy made the point to highlight that till date they've not yet fully told him what exactly the goings on are, but he's ready to cooperate anyway and is cooperating until they are able to then find their voice to open their mouth and say this is what we are doing, because he remains unclear, at least from the readings of what is being said, as to what these people exactly are doing. So that is what Ambode said. So now let's carry on. The statement reads, this morning, operatives of Economic and Financial Crimes Commission visited the Epe home and Parkview residence of Mr. Akinwumi Ambode, former governor of Lagos State, with warrants to conduct a search. These searches were carried out extensively, and at the end of the exercise, the operatives left without any incident. The former governor reiterates that the EFCC has till date not had any direct communication with him on any subject matter whatsoever, and if or when it occurs, he was ready and willing to respond. The former governor wishes to assure his supporters and the generality of Lagosians to continue to remain calm and law-abiding, as there was no cause for alarm. The former governor reiterated his belief in the rule of law and due process and remains grateful for the opportunity to have served Lagos State diligently and conscientiously. It will be recalled that Ambode, in an earlier response to allegations by the EFCC that it had frozen certain accounts linked to him, insisted that no account of his contained 9.9 billion Naira, let alone being frozen by the commission, as those accounts were opened and operated by the Lagos State government. So now this is now Ambode now, just adding a bit of background detail to the goings on here, because you know what Nigerians are like. As soon as they hear Ambode's house raided, they will immediately make up the background to that story and add the salt and Maggi and Jara. They will add all sorts of banana and pepper and spices, and before you know it, they could even say that they found all manner of this. They will say they found a truck full of dollars or something, and all this. You know how we make up stories in that country. So before they start making up stories on his behalf, Ambode has come out to say, look, this is what is going on, this is what happened, this is where we are at the stage of the process, this is what I know, this is what I don't know, and I will keep you informed as the story evolves. Don't get too carried away and don't get too excited. I will cooperate with the law of the land as I should, and the law of the land, of course, should follow due process as it should. So this is effectively what Ambode is now saying, but of course we all know that Ambode really is being kobokoed by Tinubu. This is really what is going on. He's taking some lashings from Tinubu for being a naughty boy and going above his station to try and be outperforming Tinubu and to become a shining light to try and attack his 2023 ambitions. This is really what is going on, but that's the subtext to this greater happening, or is this a sub act to a greater subtext? I don't really know what the permutations are, but of course we can see the puppet master's hand up the hollowed parts of the puppet and moving its mouth and orchestrating. So the orchestra master, of course, is the Baba Kekere or the Baba Nla of Lagos State, the Tinubu man himself, who talks in a very funny voice, ta 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 ta, you know, like some we all know that is partial to that white substance. That's the rumor. Anyway, let me not go in that direction. Conversations, though, in the comment section is what I am inviting. What are your thoughts? Ambode now being attacked frontally and in every direction. First, they blocked him from the ministerial list. Now they are attacking him in Ekpe. So no rest for the wicked, and no rest even for the saintly is really what is going on now. Because I am really curious to see what you guys are making of all this, because my reading of this whole situation is that it is really Tinubu that is orchestrating this, because there's nothing especially about Ambode's tenor that should excite this much attention from the EFCC, because that guy did not really have that reputation for I'm sure he is corrupt as well, because there's no one Nigerian politician that is not corrupt. So of course I'm sure he took care of himself during his 4 years in government, because this is just now we are all resigned that to that now as a thing in Nigeria, that anybody that is in any public office would take care of themselves. But then of course this Ambode regime, it did not have the reputation for being a corrupt regime. The reputation, the abiding name that Ambode had in his 4 years in that position was being a performer. So now why this new link now to try and tarnish his name? And look at the amount, 9.9 billion naira is 9.9 billion naira, and 9.9 billion naira is an absolute fortune to somebody like myself, is an absolute fortune to somebody like yourself, but somebody that was the governor of Lagos State, 9.9 billion naira is not really that much an amount, really. It's not really a lot of money. If they're saying 900 billion naira, then we're really now talking in the realms of real corruption, but 9.9 billion naira is not a significant amount of money for this guy to damage his name over. So now what is exactly going on is really what we really need to understand, because of course this story goes beyond this 9.9 billion naira or this chasing around with EFCC. We can see the puppet master's hand up the puppet dummies behind in this whole orchestration that we're watching now. Or what do you read into this? Conversations in the comment section as usual, but before you come join me to have that chat, click on the red subscribe button so it turns gray. Bell button notifies you every time I drop a new video. Then come join me in the comment section where we carry on. So I'll leave you here, carry on with you there, but here I say peace.